Hi, today I'd like to show you how to have a little bit of fun with a template I found. Now, I went shopping in a quilt shop recently. Who would do a thing like that? And whilst I was there, I saw this wonderful template and I thought, what can I do with that? And I had no idea. So I brought it home and I followed its instructions and I made something to do with it. So it's this little square which just I'm holding against the packaging that it came with so that you can see it's got these lines on it. So what it does is helps you make a unit. Turn it around the same way as a template, that looks like that. So it's kind of like a little bit of a wedge, not really sure, kite shape, I think we'll call it, because that's the pattern that they've given you with the template, is called kites. So I'll just quickly show you how to use that template, because it's kind of a fun little template to use. I've really enjoyed it. So in order to make this unit that I've got here, you need to have 1 5-inch square and 1 rectangle of your background colour, which is these two bits to the side, where I've done white on here. I'm using a soft grey here, and that needs to be 3 inches by 6 inches. And the template comes with all these instructions. So on your 5-inch square, which is going to be this bit that comes through the middle of the square here, it would be very helpful if you marked with a pen, pencil, doesn't really matter, at the 2.5-inch halfway. You could fold it if that was any easier, if you just want to pop a little finger press just on those edges. You need to know where that 2.5-inch mark is on, well, actually two of the sides, but if you mark them on 4, it doesn't really matter. Because then you're going to cut using a ruler from the point out to one of those marks that's 2.5 inches along. So halfway along one side to the point, lay your ruler on, and I have already marked mine. I've just used a pencil and popped a little mark at 2.5 inches there. And I'm going to lay the ruler through the point here and through that 2.5-inch mark there. And I'm going to cut that edge off. Now, you don't actually need that edge. You could use it for something else. And then we need to do the same thing. So I'll sit it back on so it looks still square. So we've done one that came off there. And now we're going to do from that same point to this other side over here, through again, through at 2.5 inches. And I'm going to just cut that. So much fun. Look at that. So we've cut our little kite shape already. So these we don't need unless you were going to use them somewhere else in a quilt. And now with our background rectangle, this was cut at 3 inches by 6 inches. This ends up being a 4.5-inch unit, so a 4-inch finished little block, just so that you know. And now I just need to cut this through diagonally. So from one point to the other, and make that into two places to replace basically the ones that we've cut off. They're just a little bit bigger, which just allows a little bit of seam allowance. So we're going to pop one on there, and we're going to pop one on there. So we're going to just lay that on top. Now, probably the easiest way, the points are not going to match at this end, so try and work it out from this edge. If you've got it so that your point overlaps 1/4 inch, so that when you start sewing at your 1/4 inch seam, your point intersects at that point. This end here is just going to be longer, so don't panic too much about that end. Start with this end and get this edge correct. So I'm going to go to the sewing machine now. So my point is sticking out, so that if I start sewing 1/4 inch in from this edge, I'm going to intersect at that point. So I'm going to go to the sewing machine and start sewing again with my regular 1/4 inch seam allowance. Now, this is on a bit of a diagonal. Both of these cuts that we've made have created a diagonal. So just be careful, because it could become a little bit stretchy. Be careful that it doesn't stretch as you sew. So I'm just coming down to this point, being careful not to stretch anything as I go. Stopping there. Now I'm going to press that seam away from the colour in towards the background. So that again, that point's a little bit tricky, but just let it press over. And that's looking pretty good so far. And now I've got my other wedge to sew on the side there, which is going to bring it back into more or less a square shape again. So same thing here, we're going to overlap so that that point just sticks out just the right amount. And I've turned it over because I find it easier to sew in this direction. And it shows you what I'm coming up against with the overlap as well. So again, just with that 1/4 inch seam allowance, being careful not to stretch as you sew. And so it's going to overlap here, and it all looks a little bit messy here. So don't worry about that too much. Just keep on sewing until you come out the other side. And again, press that into the background. Just taking care that you're not stretching anything as you press. So what we've got now, it's a very kite looking shape because we've got little tails on it too, but we're actually going to trim those tails off. Let's switch that iron off. And now this is where the template really comes into its own, because this enables us to trim this up. So we probably could trim this up just with a regular ruler, but we'll get a much better result using this template, because presumably that's what it was designed for. So if you can see that, the markings on the template are the same as these seam lines. So if you can lay that so that the point here sits in the point of our joining, so that the lines basically sit right over our sewing line. And so you should be a little bit bigger all the way around, and we're just going to trim that away now. Just holding that template nice and straight on there. And then we can turn that around to get the other bit, turn the template round. That should now sit right on those cut edges that you've just done. Everything should still be sitting just the way you want it with your markings, the point marking, and we just trim these other two sides and right through that bulky bit there. And then you've got this really nice square at the end of it, which could of course go on point, can go either way, depending on how you're going to use it. So that was the one I had. That's the one I've made. It comes out of measuring 4.5 inches, so that's going to be 4 inches finished. So I'll show you. I've made a couple of little samples using this. It was a fun little shape to use, and again, using 5-inch squares, which I always really enjoy. So I've made up this one here just in two colours. So I've used the dark grey for my background and this wonderful spoolie fabric that I discovered in a shop. Oh, I do like shopping. And so that's, of course, you can imagine that on a much bigger quilt, it would make this lovely sort of star chain throughout the quilt of just putting the blocks together and just rotating them. So this block would be here, this block would be here, etc. So that they're all rotated. So you could make a block of four, or you could make the star as your block. So I did a couple of little illustrations in my book that I draw everything in, of whether you just do repeat stars. This was for this size little quilt that I've just made, or whether I had that sort of star more in the middle, which is the way I've done it. And then I thought, well, I have another little play and I might sash in between it. So I've done that. I haven't quilted this yet, but I thought you'd like to see the sample. Softer colours. I've used white for my main background and I've sashed in between each block. But I've only put a coloured sashing post in between it, in the middle of this sort of star that's made. But again, that will give you a chain that follows right through. I quite like these chain type quilts, and I'm going to be quilting that and doing some borders on it. You'll probably see this quilt again if you watch more videos. So that was using that tool that I found in a delicious quilting shop, because quilting is so delicious and shops are delicious too. So that was that. It's called a 4.5 inch on point ruler that's put out, and it's to make that little shape there, which you can use in so many different ways. Enjoy it.